Tell me, what do you think is the future of Christianity?
I think everybody that loves Christ or knows Christ, whether they're conscious of it or not, they're members of the body of Christ. And that's what God is doing today. He's calling people out of the world for his name, whether they come from the Muslim world or the Buddhist world or the Christian world or the non-believing world. They are members of the body of Christ because they've been called by God. They may not even know the name of Jesus, but they know in their heart that they need something that they don't have, and they turn to the only light that they have, and I think that they are saved and that they're going to be with us in heaven.
This is fantastic. I'm so thrilled to hear you say that. There's a wideness in God's mercy.
There is. There definitely is.
By the way, Henry Donovan has just invited me to have lunch with all their editors here on March the 7th, and I was quite amazed because this is the first time I've heard from Time News, I mean Time Magazine, since Henry Lizard.
Yeah, you need to
call
their editors when
they're
going to start. Yeah. Need to say, I'm sure it's a very important point. I'm a lot of control there. In the mind that's totally dominated by the Jews. Those Jews totally sold by Jews and dominated by the territorial Jews. The New York Times, the White Post, totally Jewish. The evidence and the ownership of CP and Los Angeles Times now totally unfurled a scanner system of authority. The other thing, though, is that all three networks, except for the Anton and the RJ Center, frankly, or that persuasion, but the right majority was 95% of Jews. Now, what does this mean? Does it mean that that all Jews are bad? No. It does mean that all Jews are, by the way, way particularly the younger ones like that, in a way out of their rank. Their piece of any rights, except for the support of the people concerned. The only thing that we've done by us on this is and this is the real reason, the best Jews actually are the Israeli Jews, because Israel, the reason Mrs. Mayer supports me, which she does, and Diane does too, is for a very fundamental reason, has nothing to do with, they know these Iraqi candidates, we cater to the domestic Jewish vote. She supports me because she knows the great engineer did it really right. And she knows that if the crisis is all in charted, that I face the Russians down for them. She knows I'm the only one who will do it. She knows that they never kind of gave you the comments to the Russians. See, that's the point. She's talking. We talked about this. Rabin's the same way. Rabin, of course.
Oh, yeah.
The Russian Jew. Boy, does he know that. Now, but however, in this country, we must be under no illusion. You're aware of that, aren't you? You're aware of the fact that in the media, we confront almost a solid block of people that they don't listen to the aim, and then he's the point of the thing. They're after him because he put the whole thing off, and it's not due to him, it's not just, it happens so that insofar as the media is concerned, the power of the media.
They've got it.
They've got it right by.
And they're the ones putting out the pornographic stuff. They're putting it out on everything. And they had the whole thing, you see. And if he went about it wrong. But this stranglehold has got to be broken, or this country is going to go down the drain.
You believe that?
Yes, sir.
I can never say it, but I believe it.
Nobody can. But I think the second time, you might be able to do something. When Henry Luce died, they dropped me just like a, you know, he sort of promoted me for years in my work. But since you've been president, I've had to be quiet on just about everything that would make any news due to the fact I didn't want to look like I was critical of some policy of yours or be interpreted as political and so forth. So I have had to, you know, watch a little bit on the things that I would say that normally would make news. For example, even when Mr. Eisenhower was president, I spoke out against the way we were giving to India, and Mr. Dulles called me after his home to explain it to me, and oh, I would talk out against this or that or the other. Yeah. Well, it would make news. But with you as president, I feel like, you know, I can't do that.
The really scary thing is that the media control used to be certain places that writers on television have always been Jewish, Japanese, writers, all those people there, and they were always in it. But now, what's become? The old-time press corps, the old-time White House press corps, wasn't Jewish. It was, it requested a lot of liberals, a lot of soft brands, and their grandparents thought it was not Jewish. That's right, the Gridiron was very much. It was the American Smiths and the Dick Wilsons and the Triadrics and all that kind of people. But if you look at what covers the president today, and it's really kind of scary. From Time Magazine, it's Jerry Schenker. From the Drawback of Times, Craswell, Daily Times, Anywhere, Max Frankel, from the Washington Post, it's Sarno, Sandy Carno, and these are the people who are going with me on these trips. From NBC, it's Herb Kaplow. From CBS,
You know, I mean, I don't care how conservative, I'm sure I'm more conservative than you are, at least you told me that one time, and I think that's true, but I have to lean a little bit, you know, I go and I see friends with Mr. Rosenthal at the New York Times and people of that sort, you know, and not all the Jews, but a lot of the Jews are great friends of mine, they swarm around me, they're friendly to me. because they know that I'm friends with Israel, but they don't know how I really feel about what they're doing to this country, and I have no power, no way to handle much of it. But I would stand up if, you know, under proper circumstances.
But you do have a way to handle it.